بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear brothers and sisters, we know that the greatest 10 nights of the year are the last 10 nights of the blessed month of Ramadan. But did you know that the greatest 10 days of the year are the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah? In fact, so great are these days that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says there are no days during which the righteous action is so pleasing to Allah azza wa jal than these days. And he was referring to the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. So one of the companions asked, he says, O Prophet of Allah, even jihad in the cause of Allah? So he replied sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, even jihad in the cause of Allah, except in the case of which someone leaves with his life and his property and he doesn't return with either of it. This is how great these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are. So this is a perfect opportunity for you and I, my brothers and sisters, to get involved and to increase in the great worship in every act of ibadah in this great month. In fact, he was asked sallallahu alayhi wasallam, O Prophet of Allah, what about fasting on the day of Arafat, the ninth day of Dhul Hijjah? So he sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he replied, he said, fasting on this day is an expiation of your preceding year and the current year of sin. So you get 2 years where Allah Azza wa Jal will wipe away your minor sins for fasting one day. Imagine you fasted all the days of. Imagine we fasted the whole first 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. We know in the authentic hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, whoever fasts one day, sunnah, nafil, for the sake of Allah, you fast one day, Allah Azza wa Jal will remove your face from hellfire a distance of 70 years. Imagine when you fast on a day that is one of the greatest 10 days. So my brothers and sisters, we have a golden opportunity to take advantage of these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Be it fasting, be it giving in charity, be it doing a good action, be it smiling in the face of your brother or your sister, be it visiting your family and your relatives, be it reading the Quran, the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. We need to take advantage of this. And we know that on the ninth day, we know that on the day of Arafat, we know this is a very special day because all those who are performing Hajj, they're there, they're standing on the plains of Arafat, having a lifetime of sin forgiven. We can also partake in this. We can also share of this day by fasting on this day and having our sins forgiven for 2 years, my brothers and sisters. So once again, we have a golden opportunity to take advantage of these blessed days and to completely indulge yourself and reap and take from the treasures of Allah Azza wa Jal. And let us not forget that my qurban is their qurban.